I'm going to highlight the humanistic approach. In this, I may focusing on the Maslow hierarchy needs. So in the case of the humanistic approach, the two great psychologists, they given very good theories. One is called Maslow, other one is called Carl Rogers. These two theories only we are going to discuss in the name of humanistic approach. Just I'm moving to the slides. Yes. Before going to the humanistic approach, we must know what is the exact meaning of humanistic approach. The last class we are discussing about the psychoanalytic theory, but in the case of the psychoanalytic theory, it is a human behavior according to this psychological theory, psychoanalytic theory. The human behavior is controlled by the internal unconscious forces. That is why we are discussing in the psychoanalytic theory id, ego, superego. So id means unconscious mind, superego. It's a conscious mind, like that we discuss it. So it means the human behavior is controlled by our internal unconscious mind only, or unconscious forces only, according to the psychoanalytic theory. In the case of the behavioral psychologists, what they're highlighting the sense, human behavior is controlled by the external factors like our neighbors, what are things is surrounding to us, it may be influencing to our human behavior. The human behavior only we are talking here as a personality. So don't be confused here, the human behavior represents a personality. So the human behavior, based on the behavior only, we can find out what kind of personality we are. So therefore, according to two theories, is talking to the different mode. The behavior psychologist told that the human behavior is controlled by the external factors, but the psychoanalyst highlighted that the human behavior is controlled by the internal factors. But the humanistic approach, what they're highlighting in the sense, they told that the humanist behavior is controlled by both internal as well as the external factors. That is why the Maslow, he don't have the positive opinion about the psychoanalytic theory. He accepts some of the views of the psychoanalytic theory. Apparently, he denied these things because we could not go with the 100% of the, we could not predict the people's personality with only in the psychoanalysis base. So there is a behavior psychology approach also maybe imperfect. Like that he believed. That's why he may call us here, Maslow, he may call us the father of humanistic approach. So I hope now you understand what is exactly humanistic psychology. Humanistic behavior is controlled by both internal as well as the external factors. It controls. And the next thing, suppose if someone's asking what is humanistic psychology, immediately you can understand that it's a blending of the two psychologies. It is mingled with the two psychologies approach. One is called behavior psychology, other one is a psychoanalytic psychology. This combination of two psychologies is called as humanistic psychology. It is nothing but this is called internal conscious mind or unconscious mind. This is called the external, therefore IE factors. So in the case of IE factors may involve in the case of the humanistic psychology. So I move to the next slide. Yes, so in this, the humanist perspectives, no? What they're highlighting, the humanistic psychologists, the healthy rather than sick, they are much focusing on the healthy mind, healthy personality. And see the case of the other theory like Sigmund Freud and all, he observed only the problematic people. That is why he coined the theory like the ego, superego, and he much focused on the psychoanalytic things because he met the people only those are having the issues, mental issues or some kind of delinquent issue. For them only he met, from this only he coined the theories and all. But he focuses, the humanistic psychology focusing that healthy mind rather than the sick minds. So they are talking about the fulfillment of the people with the use of, it means that the healthy mind, psychological health, and the mind should be functioning in a healthy way. So that is their targeting. And the individual is greater than some of the test scores. Okay, they are thinking about the individual scores, individual person's things is greater than the sum of the test scores, like that, based on the theoretical things, he given some kind of importance in these aspects. And these two theoretical the psychologists we are going to discuss in the name of humanistic approaches. One is called Maslow. He coined the theory, I hope you already know these Maslow hierarchy needs. So even the theory is focusing on motivation, but the motivation theory, it may link with personality also. Then second theory, Carl Rogers, he made the theory in the name of person-centered perspectives. But today's class, I'm focusing on the Maslow hierarchy needs only. He's a man, Maslow hierarchy, Maslow. He only coined the, made this particular theory. And Maslow hierarchy theory of personality states that people achieve their full potential by moving from basic needs to self-actualization. So his target, the fulfillment is represented here, self-actualization. So those are reaching the high designation or high level, the people is called as here, psychological health mind people. They reach the self-actualization state according to him. And as a leader of humanistic psychology, as I already mentioned that he's a father of humanistic psychology. The Abraham Maslow approached the study of personality by focusing on subject experiences. That is the main problem of the theory. That is why some of the psychologists after the Maslow, they have a lot of critics about the Maslow theory because his theory is not talking about any kind of empirical evidence. Maslow theory is not talking about any empirical evidence. From his subjective experiences only, he coined this this particular theory. That is why a lot of criticisms this theory is having. And Maslow expanded the field of humanistic psychology to include explanations of how human needs change throughout the individual lifespan. How the human needs change throughout the individual span. How these needs, once fulfill the needs, in what way the personality may influence, like this in this theory, and how these needs influence the development of personality. This is the main focus of this particular theory. Once again, I'm highlighting this point. Maslow, he expanded the field of humanistic psychology to include an explanations of how human needs change throughout an individual's lifespan and how these needs influence the development of personality. This is main contributions in the case of the personality. We may have the confusion, but this theory is focusing on the motivation only, and the needs only. Then how it will be linked with personality. But here there is a link is happened. How these needs may influence in the case of the development of personality, that we have to look on deeply while I'm explaining. And Maslow hierarchy needs ranks human needs from most basic physical needs to the most advanced needs of self-actualization. That we I'm going to explain with the use of some kind of diagram representations. I'm going to highlight his brief introduction about the Maslow. He was born in April 1, 1908. He's basically from New York. He died in June 8, 1970, at the age of 62. The California High died. He's basically the nationality American. His field is psychology. And he did the courses Cornell University, Brooklands College. Alma mater is nothing but he's also did some other courses. That's why he's like an alumni member. Okay, the University of Wisconsin-Madison. And his known contributions in the case of the psychology is nothing but Maslow hierarchy needs. So this is a brief introduction about him. And see, the Maslow is considered, I already mentioned, he's the father of humanistic psychology. Then this is called as a third force. Please, this question may come to the mid-examination. Then if humanistic psychology is the third force, what is the first force? What is the second force? That question may arise from our end. The first force of the psychology is called behaviorism. The second force of the psychology is called as psychoanalysis. The third force is called as humanism. So that is why the humanism, it's a combination of the behaviorism as well as the psychoanalysis. That is a blending of the two isms. This is the hierarchical, Maslow hierarchical needs. I already mentioned that Maslow hierarchy of needs ranks the human needs from the most basic physical needs to the most advanced needs of self-actualization. That is why the down, if you are finding the physical safety, love, belongingness, and the extreme, then finally the people's self-actualization. Who they reach the self-actualization distance? Those are fulfilled. So if the persons fulfill these four needs, then only they are able to go to the self-actualization. So suppose in between one person, so like there is not in between, because if once you reach the physicality needs to be fulfilled only, we can move to the safety needs. We can pursue the safety needs. once we fulfill the safety needs, then we can think about the love and blindness. Like that, there is a linkage between the each needs is there. Just I'm going to be highlight the each needs one by one with some meaningful picture representations. And this is also the same diagram only, but here I'm using the terms of pyramid. Because it may be a triangle, but if you look onto the three dimension, it may call it a pyramid. And the first two needs is called the basic needs. The first two needs is called basic needs. So the basic needs is comes, which are things may incorporate in the sense physical needs as well as the safety needs. So what the person to live in the world, in the sense they have to fulfill the basic needs. One is the physical needs as well as the safety. Then after fulfilling the basic needs, the people may think about the needs and affections. Once the people fulfill the psychological and basic needs, they may think about the self-actualization. Finally, they may move to the self-fulfillment. Self-fulfillment, that is nothing but the self-actualization needs. So this is here some kind of linkage between the needs. Yeah, so this is the same thing. But in the case of the Maslow hierarchy, the down one is called as the lower needs. So once you fulfill the lower needs only, we can move to the upper needs. The upper needs consist of the three things. What is the love and belongingness, then self-esteem and self-actualization. The first two things is called basic needs, that is called lower needs. And this is a basic, so without the basic, we cannot move to the next level, according to the Maslow. Yeah, the same thing, I'm coming to the one by one. The first things, physical needs. So in the physical needs, this normally, it consists of, or this includes the needs we have for even for oxygen, water, protein, salt, sugar, calcium, and other minerals and vitamins, which are the things need to survive. Physically, we need to satisfy something. Then only we can be surviving this world. So this is the thing called as the physical needs. Just I'm highlighting the physical needs. One is the food, because for the person, we are living because of the fulfill the our stomach. So if we are not eat the food, we are not thinking about the other things and all. Therefore, the basic needs of every people, food, then air. Suppose you are not getting the good air, we cannot be living this world. Then water. Water is another important thing. Then rest and sleep. Then sex. So these are some of the basic needs. It's come under the physical needs. So if none of the things are not satisfied, we are not thinking about the next level of safety. Because see this case, those you can find some of the beggars in the outside. They don't have the shelter, they don't have the homes and all. Because still they are fulfilling because they are not able to fulfill the daily food things. So daily they are begging to us, they are getting the money from this, they are eating. That's why they are not thinking about the next needs, safety and security. So that is why those who are living in the platforms and all, their basic needs only the food only. They are not thinking, for example, if they are getting the regular food, daily they are getting the food, they may think about some kind of homes. They may find some kind of security later. But the people's not getting the regular food, that is why still they are living in the platform itself. So this is the basic needs, this comes with food, air, water and rest as well as these things. Also there is the need to active, I have already mentioned the rest, sleep. Parallelly the sex. Sex also is one of the praying things in the case of the physical needs. This is also mentioned by Maslow video. And in what way it may influence in the classrooms. So in what way in the classroom applications we have to fulfill the physical needs. That is why the free, we have the lunch hours in the periods. And apparently the governments now they focus on the free lunch programs. Previously also the lunch programs are there. And now they are providing egg and some kind of other hygienic food also they are sharing. This is in this manner only the physical needs may satisfy in the classrooms, in the particular institution and all. And the rooms, we need a correct room temperatures. That is for air, Then bathroom and drink break should be compulsory in the case of to fulfill the physical needs of the students in the institutions. So I'm parallelly comparing with how the physical needs we had to fulfill in the classrooms. That also I'm focusing. The second one is called safety and security needs. It is a level two. Once the people are satisfying the level one of the physical needs, they may think about or they may move to the safety and security needs. And the physical needs are largely taken care of, the second layers of the needs come into the play. So once they fulfill the first layer only, they move to the second one. And here, what are the things much focusing the sense? One is called safe circumstances. So after getting the food, proper food daily, they get in this, they may think about their life to settle in the homes, but how the circumstances, the stability and protections, these are things the people might think about the next level. One is called security. In their homes, whether they have the proper security to live, then next is a protection. That is why, suppose in any flood or any kind of natural disaster comes, the people's having the lot of problem they face because they don't have the protections, the safety, and due to that only they are going to the first level. So once they fulfill, for example, some of the people, they fulfill the second level, but there is a natural disaster is coming, in the sense they could not find the regular homes, the staying homes after the disaster came. That's why they move to the first level. Once again, they are searching for the food one. So in this manner, sometimes the reverse also may reflect. Suppose if some people may reach the second level, safety and security level. In this level also, they have some kind of issue, then they move to the first level itself. So that we have to think. Then they say employability. After getting the things, the people may fight for the employability. Once they get the employability, they may think about the third level. That's called love and belongingness. That is a property. Property, this is at least we have to live in a proper place. That place should be our own. Like that, the people may think. This is come under the safe and security needs. Home protection, employability, pain, even for the staying, no? So that things we can think, we don't think about the pain awareness. If the pain comes, we don't be accept these things at all. The property. So this may come to the safety needs. It's a second things. In what way we can incorporate in the education settings, the safety needs in the sense? We have to keep some kind of emergency procedure. That is why everywhere they are using the fire. If any emergency happened, so in the theater and that you can see these things. If you go to the Kasaragod theater, everywhere they are using the fire. If any emergency happened to rectify the things, they are using some kind of firing hazmation things they are keeping in the hotel or anywhere. And in the schools and all, they can keep some kind of fire discipline to avoid some kind of fighting things within the students. This kind of safety measures we have to take care in the education settings. The third level, once the people are reaching the first two level, they may think about the love and blanks, the third level of things. There the people searching the friends, then affectionate relationship, and they make it some kind of sense of community, the close sense of community in this the third stage. So they expecting the love and the affection from others. Once they get the love and affection from others, only they may give to us. But the problem with love and affection, there is no unconditional love. So everywhere we can find out the conditional love only. But if you are getting the unconditional love, it is a very good thing. And the friendships, we are expecting the friendship. Then main thing is acceptance. Sometimes we have a friend, but that friendship is not close nature. Why? In the sense, we may feel that he's a great friend, one or next person, but they're not having the proper concern with us. They're not accepting us as a friend. So normally the friendship is a give and take policy. So once you share the love and affection to others, apparently we are expecting from them also the same thing. So their acceptance is the main things in the case of love and blindness, the care is. That is why while you're staying to neighbors, suppose you have got the home. Once you got the home, the second needs, if you are satisfied, no? So the second needs satisfied in the sense, you are getting some home. Then immediately we are searching for the neighbors to interact with them. We are making some kind of close bondness with our neighbors, because we fulfill these second needs, then we can having some kind of close bonds with the neighbors where you are staying. So these are the things coming to the second, third stage: affection, friendship, as well as the acceptance, then finally caring. Use one-on-one instructions. So when you talk to someone, instead of giving the instruction to the most people, better to invite these students individually and then we give the instruction. So even we can call the students with their names. That is called acceptance. So when you talk to the students, kindly call their names. And if the students are asking any questions, we have to listen to the students' questions. So, and provide a positive comments and feedback, and be supportive always. We have to give some support if they need in the sense. So in this manner, we have to make it some kind of education settings practices to fulfill the love and belonging needs in the case of the classrooms atmosphere. We have to teach, we have to speak the children's one-on-one and listen the students. Parallelly, we have to give the instructions in a alone manner instead of a group, and provide a positive comments always, because the students means they are doing some kind of wrong things only. So instead of scolding them, better to give me a suggestion to modify the behavior. And parallelly, if they did something good things, we have to give some kind of positive comments as well as the feedback, and be always supportive to the student side. The fourth one is called self-esteem. So once we fulfill the three things like physical needs, the second one is a safety, the third one is a love and blindness, then after that, people may thinking about the self-esteem. But in the case of the Maslow, he noted the two versions of self-esteems. One is a lower one, other one is a higher one. The lower one is the need of the respect of others. The lower one is talking about the respect of the others, the needs of first status, fame, glory, and then recognitions, attention, reputations, appreciation, the dignity. These are things that people are expecting from those who are having the lower self-esteem. Those are people having the high esteem, no? They're thinking about, they need to self-respect, including such feeling as confidence, self-confidence, the competency, achievement, mastery, independency, as well as the freedom. This is the people, those who are, finding this kind of needs, they call us here high self-esteem people. But generally, we need a high self-esteem instead of a low self-esteem. But once you fulfill the low esteem, only we may think about the high esteem also. But always we have to have the high self-esteem, like self-respect. Once you respect yourself, only then other people may respect you. And self-confident, then competent, competency nature, achievement, mastery level, the independency, then always to find freedom to do the things. So these are the things that may influence our the personality. Just I'm going to list out the things which is coming to the self-esteem. One is a self-respect, self-confidence, that image. Even we may be cat, when you look onto the mirror, this is called sometimes maybe superiority complex, but we need some kind of superiority complex instead of the inferiority complex. Okay, because even the inferiority complex and superiority complex may influence our personality. The next class, I may be talking about the ideal self, the real self. There, we may know that what is a superiority complex, what is an inferiority complex. Then self-confident. So this image talking much about the self-confident. Then appreciation. So we have to give appreciation, and we have to reach some kind of achievements. And the success, always we have to find the success once you reach the self-esteem. This is the things is made in the case of the self-esteem in the society. In what way we have to incorporate these things in our classroom settings, in the sense, involve all the students in class participation and responsibility. We have to conduct some kind of programs because each one's having the competent in some aspects. That some people, they are good in the language, some people they are good in the athletic skills, some people they are very good in the aesthetic dance and all. So we have to conduct a regular interval lot of competitions. From this, we have to find the good people in the particular competent people, and we have to award them. This kind of award candidate competition may develop the self-esteem. Then we have to go with the cooperative learning things, because in the schools and all, there is a I don't know whether it's happened now, that is called the last hours. No, the teachers may divide the classroom into small group, The first week, one leader may act, the second week, the another leader. Like that, the classroom having some kind of collaborative learning happen. The last hours, I don't know whether it's happening in that situations. The last one needs of each layer, but when the four layers to over, needs was a vital role to develop the personality. So each the layer of the needs, it's having the much influence in the personality. The highest needs of the self-actualization represent the achievements of our fullest potential, and those individuals who finally achieve self-actualizations were said to represent optimal psychological health and functioning. Maslow, he also stressed that the field of psychological study to include fully functional individual instead of only those with psychosis, and he said a more positive lights on the personality psychology. That is why he may call us a father of humanisms, and he observed the Maslow. No, he observed some of the great personalities. From this only he made this theory. So he observed Albert Einstein, Thomas Jefferson, as well as the Abraham Lincoln, and others. So he studied of the personality of this much of people, and he found that such people, this much of people, he observed. No, observe means it's not directly observing. So he's comparing the personality of all the four members together. And finally, he came to know that they have the similar characteristics, and such that feeling that characteristics like open-mindedness, creative, loving, spontaneous, then concern with others, concern for others, and accepting of themselves. So these are the common characteristics they found from these people. So these characteristics he may can keep it as a self-actualization people. So from that people only he came come to the conclusion that these are the characteristics good in the case of the self-actualization. And Maslow viewed that self-actualizers are the supreme achievers. So those are reaching the self-actualization stage, they are the supreme achiever in the human race. He studied standard the individual in order to better understand what characteristics they possess that allow them to achieve the self-actualization. Just I'm going to highlight the things which involved in the self-actualization. One is the fulfillment. So the persons to understand who am I. For example, if you understand who am I, or you understand what is your life, the contribution to society, or what is the existence of you, that if you understand, that is the fulfillment of our life. So that examinations, he observed Albert Einstein, then other things, and the express beliefs. Then help others. So I'm highlight some of the personalities here. They are the examples of the self-actualizers. Then creative thinking. So I already mentioned that some of the characteristics is common for this much of people. One is the open-mindedness, accepting others. They are very creative. They are sharing the love and affection to all the people, and they have the concern about others. So these are the basic characteristics to reach the self-actualization, achieve full potential, fulfillment, express beliefs, help others, creative thinking. And in what manner, so these are some of the people I listed here as self-actualization people. In what manner we have to incorporate these things to university education settings? Expect students to do their best. So we can provide some kind of, provide some kind of space to the student to do something. Like we can assign some kind of project work without intervening much. Without intervening much, we have to give a lot of freedom to the student. The freedom is talking about the self-expression. If you are providing the freedoms, we can easily to find out the creativity ability of the students. Give the students freedom to explore, discover on their own. Plan lessons involving metacognitive. You can provide some kind of lesson activity to understand the metacognition things about them. Then allow students to be involved creative activity and projects. From this only, we can understand the self-actualization things about the children. So apparently, the lot of criticism happened in the Maslow theory. That criticism only I may highlight it here. The criticism I already mentioned that his theory, he made only the subjective observation only. He is not doing any kind of empirical things. That is a main problem of his theory. So that is why most of the psychologists they're criticizing his theory in high manner. Just I'm going to list you the points. Maslow's ideas have been criticized for the lack of scientific rigor. As with all yearly psychology studies, questions have been raised about the lack of empirical evidence. I already mentioned the lack of empirical evidence used in his research, because his things mainly focus on the subject nature of the study. The holistic approach allows to a great deal of variations, but does not identify enough constant variable in order to be a research with a true accuracy. So his theory, he is not highlighting any empirical evidence. Therefore, we cannot find the true accuracy about his research work. That is the main problem of his work. That is why most of the psychologists who come from author works, they criticize his theory. Yes, thank you all. I hope now we understand what is Maslow hierarchy needs, in what manner the needs may influence the personality. So thank you all.